How are you doing? Welcome to live stream number 133. My name is Lars Christensen, and thank you so much for taking the time to join today's YouTube live stream. Today's topic is the future of Fusion 360. We're going to take the roadmap for what's coming with Fusion and talk a little bit about some settings, idea station, just kind of like trying to keep this one a little short. And not get too long and too boring. But I think this is important and can be also be exciting. So we already got Lucas here, got Piet here. Absolutely love it. Thank you so much for taking the time to watch these. Even if you're watching the recording, you can't make it live. So let's talk a little bit about the roadmap. And I'm inside of Fusion because you can actually access all this stuff right inside of Fusion 360. If you go up and you click the little question mark up here, you will find different things in here. And one of the ones in here is a product roadmap. You click on that and your web browser should open up. And you will see here that while I was on leave, Kiching, who writes these, he's a great guy, really good writer actually. He puts this product roadmap together here. Now, I would recommend, if you are interested, I know some of you guys are gonna go out and read this detail to detail, and again, Kiching is awesome at writing these, but I thought that maybe today we will go through it a little bit quicker and just show you some of the things that is coming that I know you guys have emailed me about. And by the way, my email address, lars.christensen@autodesk.com. Down in the description area, email me any future topics. But I know that some of you guys have kind of like asked for some of these things, so it's gonna be exciting. So I just wanna run through it quick. I'm not gonna read it, hold on, because I'm not gonna waste too much time. Great intro by Kiching, I recommend you read it. Let's talk a little bit about performance and reliability. Talk a little bit about what is coming. By the way, and I want to kind of like just make sure, Fusion should run pretty stable on your machine. You should not see all different kinds of issues. Then there might be something that can be tweaked. Inside of Fusion, be aware of that you have a graphics diagnostic area. If you click on that same question mark I clicked on before, in here, and you can actually go down and change some options for better performance versus better graphics. And you can see how if you're still experiencing problems. So I just want to add that up because they are working really hard on making sure. It was found right on the question mark there under graphic diagnostics. The team is working really, really hard on making sure that, you know, there's no issues. And I can tell you that there have been a couple of times, I don't think it's very often that there have been some issues with kind of like the cloud service. And I can tell you just my two cents, and I'm the bus boy. I'm not high up in the standings, but it's taken very, very serious when those things happen. So it's definitely not taken lightly. All right, enough of this. So in this section here, talking a little bit about how we're working on new things coming, trying to streamline the menus a little bit, just trying to make things smoother. Then we come down to some things here that I think some of you guys might like. So we have a couple of things that we are working on. One of the ones is called a desktop connector. What is really trying to create almost on Windows or Mac, but almost trying to create an access in your browser here to go out to your cloud files. And then also something that is pretty exciting called AnyCAD that have existed in inside of Inventor for a few years is coming into to Fusion also with strong strength. What those are, the AnyCAD portion is really, some of you guys already work with this. you're getting files from other systems like SolidWorks, or you get them as a neutral format like STEP or IGES, and then you bring them in and convert them into Fusion. Well, with AnyCAD, you're actually not really converting. You're literally looking straight at them. I will show more about this on the live streams. We'll definitely dig into that. Fusion Production is a new product. We're going to do something on Fusion Production here on the channel soon. It is really good. If you are a job shop doing CNC work, maybe I would say 5 to 20 machines or so, this is a way that you can monitor the work on the shop floor. I was involved in this project, so I have some videos on that I'm going to share on the channel. I'm just going a little fast through this because I think for some of you guys, this is like before we get to the nitty gritty. So highlight Fusion, the data management portion, the AnyCAD, like I just talked about, the desktop connector. So they're working on that in progress. So just so you know that what the team is working on, I'm going to show you in just a couple of seconds where you can get more of this. And by the way, some people are coming in here late. This is the roadmap that was just released last month, and you can get to it inside of Fusion. If you click up here on the little question mark in the upper right and you click product roadmap, that way you can read every single detail if you're interested. I just thought we'll fly through it fairly quickly here. So that is some of the things that they're working on. Other things that, if we have any educators in here, the lab environment. So if you have like a classroom full of computers versus the students' own workstations, that's going to be better. Some people's going to start getting excited. What we see here, they are working on the custom keyboard shortcuts. So it's not like the team don't know that you guys want this. It's more about, you know, kind of like get it prioritized and get it in there. They're working on it. There is some new UI, so the interface, like all the different buttons up here. The development team have some interesting things coming with that. All right, I'm gonna leave it right here so people can read down here, NPT threats. So the whole tool and the threat tools are going to come together. So right now inside of Fusion, you kind of like have this section here with the threat and the whole. They are gonna be merged coming soon. And in that, it's actually ready to go into development. And in that, they're working on adding some MP3 threats. I applaud. Whoever does that on the development team, dude, send me an email. I owe you a beer and a steak. That is absolutely awesome. Some other things you can read more on in here. I'm going to leave this one up so you guys can kind of like read this one down here. They are continually working on the sketching environment. Single line engraving front. That's one that a lot of us machinists, if you ever worked in a job shop and you got to engrave a piece of material, like with a job number or something like that, you don't want fancy front. You just want a single line front. That is coming. It's actually ready to go. And then down here, text along a path on a curve. It is being planned. They are working on it. They're aware of it. They know of it. So that is good. Some new things with rendering, with simulation in here. Good stuff. All you can read it yourself. I don't want to waste all of people's time. I just want to show what I think really is nice. 2D drawings. That's another thing that I know a lot of people email me about. Title block editing. That is worked on. Part list enhancements. That's another thing that I know that a lot of you guys email me about. My email address, lars.christensen@autodesk.com. If there's any future topics you would like to see, email me about it. I can't help you getting these faster, get those through faster, the program, but I can definitely, if you have any questions or anything, definitely send it to me. And then let's get down to down here in the CAM environment. Machine definition. This is one that it's going to be kind of like a beta type thing, a preview stage. I'm going to show you that inside of Fusion just in a second. But this, I'm very excited about this. I think that's going to be cool. If any of you guys on Instagram, you have maybe seen some footage from Al Watmore, the product manager, with adaptive clearing going both ways. Some tool library enhancement. Just had a question about that in my email last night. Some drilling enhancement, 5-axis enhancement. A lot of different things in here in this roadmap as I just kind of like sped through it in less than 10 minutes. There's definitely a lot of material in here that you can go out and read for yourself. So again, if I go into Fusion, go up and click up on the help icon and you will see right here, you can click product, roadmap, and it will open up. This is a little bit different than other CAD softwares that I have worked with in the past, where the development team kind of like, I will almost say that they live in some cave somewhere or in a big castle where users never know what they're actually working on. And then once a year they come up with like a new release and then everybody kind of like gets to see what's coming. This here is, the development team is really trying to be as transparent as possible with what they're spending their time on. That said, they are pulling a lot of, don't email me about what you would like to see because they don't listen to me. Again, I'm like the busboy in a restaurant just cleaning dishes. But a place you can do that is, if you go back up to where we had the question mark for the product roadmap, right underneath here, there's submit an idea. And that will open up the idea station. And that is really where the development team goes to find out what users are requesting. So this is a really good place for you guys to go and put in any ideas. You can search in here for things. You can see in here what is popular. That's what I normally kind of like. You can go in here and say popular, and then you can kind of like see, you know, what is happening in there. It's running a little slow. Maybe a lot of people are clicking on that. So you will see some of the different things in here. This is definitely one of those places where you should know exists, right? One where you can go in and see what the team is working on and where you can submit yours. Because when it comes down to the nitty gritty, Autodesk just want to make a product that suits what you want, what you need. That's also why I try to do this, just to add a little bit more value, right? That is in everybody's interest. Now, I wanted to show one other thing, and I know this is going to be a shorter one, shorter live stream. It's probably good sometimes, I would think. I can see here there was a quick question. David is asking about any new on the Fusion 360 browser release. So I can't, there's nothing in the roadmap about it, David, but I know that there's definitely some work, serious work going on with it. I can tell you that it's definitely not stagnant. The development team are working really hard on that. What they're trying to do with, and I'm not going to open it up right now because I don't want to mess my stream more than I have to. But with the browser version, they're trying to make sure that it's stable. And that's probably the biggest thing that they're working on right now. Now, I just wanted to show you this. If we go into your name and you go into preferences, I want you to be aware of, by the way, I just talked about performance before. If you go over here to the left, in the graphics, not the graphics in here. Is that where I wanted to go? In the graphics in here, yes. You can change settings for better display or better performance in here. And this is where some of these things that can make your system work slower. So if you are seeing some issues, try to go in and change, make sure you have this on better performance. What I wanted to show in here is the preview section. So there is down here a preview section, and this is what in the olden days would call beta. But beta used to be that you had to submit if you could become beta. this has nothing to do with that. The only thing that happens is when you check one of these, you are told here that if you're saying sign me up for this, we can at least know how often you are using some of these preview functions in here. So unless you're working for the US government, making military part, and you're under high, you know, security things, you know, you can go in here and I would hit apply. So I get all these different functions that is kind of like being worked on. Okay, that was about all that I was planning on doing on today's live stream. I wanted to keep it somewhat short. It's good sometimes to have a short one. Definitely make sure that if you haven't already, if you came in late, I'm sorry if you missed this, go up on the help, check out the latest product roadmap here that Kiching put together. It's really good. And it will give you an idea about what's coming. I can't tell you exactly when the next update is coming out. And I can't tell you, like we saw some of the things in here are in yellow, so they're in progress. Some of the things are blue, planned. But there's some things that is ready to go. I'm assuming that in the next release, some of these greens will definitely be in there. And again, I'm pretty low on the totem pole. Let's just say that I think that the next release of Fusion 360 or the next update will be here within the next 5 to 12 days. That's what I have heard in the grapevines. All right, man. Sorry if you just came in and this is a short one, but I think it's good sometimes to keep them short. Product roadmap, it's definitely one of those that, you know, we want to make sure that you as a user get the functions that you're requesting. So make sure you get that idea station on your toolbar. We'll definitely appreciate the feedback if you have the time. All right, guys, I am going to end today's live stream. It's going to be a little bit short. I really appreciate, if you're watching the recording, that you took the time for that. Tomorrow, we're going to talk about how to create an exhaust manifold. We're going to get into the loft command. So we're going to do that tomorrow here on YouTube, 3 p.m. And then also there's an absolute beginner, 8 p.m. Eastern on the Facebook channel. So that's tomorrow. Tomorrow there's two live streams. Thanks so much, guys. For you guys who are watching the recording, going to end the broadcast. Thank you so much for taking the time. I really appreciate it. And for you guys who are in the live stream, I'm going to jump in and say hi to you guys. Take care, everybody.